Chris here with EcoFlow's new power stream. This is a micro inverter. I also do have this, which is the Delta 2 Max. Now, this has 2 kilowatt hour capacity. Maximum output is 2,400 watts, and they're rigid 400 watt solar panels. Now, the maximum output of it is 800 watts, so it does have its limits here. And in this video, I'll be running through it, and I'll show you exactly how the power stream micro inverter works, a little on our Delta 2 Max and these solar panels. So inside the box of our PowerStream microinverter, you find a warranty card. So it's a 10-year warranty, which is excellent. A quick start guide, which goes over everything, how to connect everything up, set it up, the application, safety instructions right there too. And this here is our bracket. So that's for the microinverter. You've also got this metal brace that you can use instead. And it does say there that its recommended use is without the battery. And we do get some screws for mounting this bracket for the microinverter. Cables included, there are a lot, and they are super high quality cables. I've even included little Velcro straps here. So this is our solar cable, clearly labeled there for solar, and you can't accidentally plug this into the wrong port on the microinverter anyway. So the typical standard solar connectors right there, high quality ones. So we've got two of them because we have the two solar inputs. So it's 400 watts on one, another 400 on the other, and that makes it 800 watts maximum with the solar input with this unit here. Now the plugs themselves, I'm really impressed with the design of them, how solid these are. So you can see the contacts are really good. We have this metal outside shield to it and it clips in. So the way it clips in is that you can't actually get it off easily. You can't just pull it out because you need to be able to pull these clips outwards first before you remove the plugs from the microinverter, which I will show you shortly. Now, the way they are designed too, that any bending or tension or stress put on this is not going to be an issue. These are rock solid cables. So that's the solar cable. Then we have our AC out cable. So this is the important one that you plug into your own home here. And then it's going to be supplying from the inverter going out here and putting the power into your network, your grid, you could say, in within your house there. Again, really high quality, this cable, and you won't be able to easily just remove that. And then this one here goes from the PowerStream micro inverter and plugs into your EcoFlow battery station there, your battery bank. And it's using a different connector there. It's a standard connector that you'll find across a whole range of models from EcoFlow with their battery stations. And again, really good quality, all of these plugs. These are called the EcoFlow Superflat MC4 cables. And they've got the standard MC4 connectors, but look at how flat this cable is. It's absolutely tiny. So the idea is this will go under a door or through around a window, and you can then close it or close that door. You don't have to drill holes. So this is perfect for people that live in an apartment or a flat that don't want to drill holes, or maybe it's not your apartment or your flat. You're renting, so you can use this instead and getting around the solution and problem of drilling, which maybe your landlord does not want. So this is the PowerStream micro inverter. It's IP67, really good build quality to it. So it's very solid. It's a solid unit here. It will have thermal paste inside it. You have the components pressed up against this metal build. So it's acting as just a big heat sink for it too. Now IP67, so there's gonna be no problem. This being out in the dust, in the weather, being rained on will not be an issue. And you'll see here at the front of it, we do have a status LED. You will see that flashing away. At the back of it, we've got 4 solid rubber feet. There are the mounting points there for the bracket or the brace and an earth contact point right there. Now the plugs, the quality of these is very good. You see they've got little caps on and that protects the components there inside. Now they are labeled. Okay, so what is right here at the top. So it's clearly labeled and you can't accidentally put the wrong plug in the wrong position anyway. So this one here is the AC out. This is our wireless antenna right here. So if they had that internal, there'd be no signal strength. So that's why they've done it. They've made it external there. And if you want to know all of the specs here of our power stream, then just hit pause. You can have a look at all of those details then. But the main takeaway here is that it is 800 watts maximum. That is our output from this, that it'll feed into your own home grid.
And then the EcoFlow smart plugs. You use this in conjunction with the power station, with everything really. And these can be operated remotely through the app. So you could be, imagine at work, and you can turn remotely on and off. You can set timers on and off too with the application. And you can even set overload protection. So you can set it at 1,000 watts right up to 2.5 kilowatts.
EcoFlow does have these 400-watt solar panels. So the rigid solar panels here can produce, what I've seen, maximum about 350 watts. So in total, I've seen just over 700 watts. And I'll show you how it is all connected up here. So the rigid 400-watt solar panels, the PowerStream microinverter, and the Delta 2 Max. And just for the purposes of this video, to make it a little bit easier for me, I have them set up here out in the garden. So the Delta 2 Max, you would have this inside your apartment. You would then have the microinverter very close by because that cable is not that long. It's not designed to be separated that far away from, of course, the battery bank itself here, the Delta 2 Max. Now, the build quality of these EcoFlow rigid solar panels, the 400 watt ones, is very good. And they have, of course, your typical solar connector. Now, you don't have to use their panels. You can supply and source your own panels, use those, they will work well. You just don't want to go over that 800 watts. That's important. You can't really do that. And I've got my assistant here, Vera, who's coming along to help me, as you can see. Hi, Vera, say hello to the world. She's always interested in what I'm up to and doing. So we've got then the microinverter that's on the top there. So this is our power stream. So that is going to be handling the flow of energy. So it'll be charging the battery. It'll be sending some of that back into the house. The great thing about the setup is that you can simply just disconnect it. So you've got that plug there, remove it, and you can just remove the whole microinverter there, the power stream, and we have then our separate battery bank you can take with you. If you need to go camping, you've got some other sort of need for it, emergency use, then you've got it here, and we have that 2,400 watts output. The back of the Delta 2 Max here is where you find our AC output ports. So these ones, 2,400, as I just mentioned, maximum there. But with XBoost on, it can take you up to 3,100, but only for short periods. It will allow you that surge there to be able to just go over that exceeded limit. So it's great for more powerful devices, maybe some power tools, hair dryers, and trying to boil water and things, which I will be testing later on in the video here. So this is our 12 volts part. On and off here, DC side of things. So 3 amps maximum there. Then we do have the car cigarette lighter socket there too, as well, as you can see. And here we've got our Xtreme Charge. So this is AC in charging, and it can fully charge really quick. Just 53 minutes to get up to 80%. There is a switch here for the fast charging mode or slow charging mode. If you happen to overload it, there's overload protection, and the reset button is right here. And we have our solar inputs. So 500 watts, this one here, 500 watts here. So that is 1,000 watts solar charge maximum. The Delta 2 Max does have active cooling. So there's some fans at the top here. It's actually quite quiet in use, this particular model here, both charging and discharging it. They say around 30 decibels too with it. So it's using, of course, the LFP battery cells there. So they're the highest quality ones that these battery stations are using. So after 3,000 cycles, the capacity of those batteries will drop down to then 80%, which is very good. And the lifetime of them, well, they say they're going to be good for 10 years, even if you are using it daily. The front of the unit here, we have our main power on and off button, status LED. It does make beep noises, but you can disable that via the application. And an on and off here for the USB ports. This DC side of things here does have USB Type-C. They are both power delivery ports up to 100 watts, so they can charge your laptops really quickly. And then the Type-A ports, we've got four of those. Two are more slower charging, USB Type-A's, and then fast charge, which support quick charge 3. These are the two blue Type-A ports. The screen is very clear, gives us all of that key information we want. So you can see the input wattage, output wattage here, percentage of our Delta 2 Max, and the remaining time that it can last at its current discharge rate, which is 56 hours, because I've got nothing connected up to it here at the moment. EcoFlow has really slimmed this unit down because the capacity of it being the 2 kilowatt hours, yet it's the size of what I see of much smaller capacities. So they claim that this is about 30% smaller than the competition. It is a heavy unit, however, because this is about 23 kilos. So it's got a bit of bulk to it. There's no wheels, but the handles on it are very good. They're nice and strong, and the build quality is excellent of the Delta 2 Max. So I'll go inside now and I'll show you how all of this works. The best way to explain it is through the application, where you do get a clear idea of the flow of energy, how the battery's being charged, what's being sent back to the house, and those smart plugs too.
Now, I do like the graphics they use, the simplicity of the application, but then it does have all the specific kind of information you want, and you can get a lot of stats out of it. So I've got two of the smart plugs hooked up. I have the Delta 2 Max and Powerstream here. So let's have a look at the Powerstream. Now, on first glance, it will tell you how much energy you have generated. So 2.14 kilowatts today so far. Your current generation, so the solar panels at almost 600 watts. The best I've seen them do is 700. Smart plugs currently using this. Other load, so this is my house. I've got a fridge freezer unit that's on. The light's here right now. And an air conditioning unit. So it's not running all of that. Some of it's going to be from the grid too as well. And our battery status there. So it's slowly discharging a little bit. Now, if you get out of this, or before I actually do that, I just want to show you all of these settings because there's a lot in here. Now, your AC output demand, I've set it to the maximum here, the 800 watts. I wanted to test that. And when you touch the top of the microinverter, it gets really hot, which is normal because it's handling a lot of current that's going through it. But it's passively cooling itself too as it does that. So you can lower that down. If you didn't want, for example, 800 watts, you want to save a little bit on your battery, not even use the battery, maybe just want it all to be solar. Set it to 320 now. So you'll see this later on. Now you've got other options here. This is one of the best ones too. Prioritize the power supply. So you can get it to have the solar panels feeding straight into your house and your current consumption. All right. Or if you need to charge or want to charge the battery for nighttime use, or you're going to take it out, you prioritize the charging of the battery. And so that is all really good, but you can schedule it too. So you can set times for that. There's a lot of options in here. The discharge and charge levels of that battery. So if you want to completely drain it, you can. It has the LFP battery cells. They're pretty much the best for this type of storage. And you've got 4,000 cycles before the capacity drops down to 70%, as I mentioned in the intro there. And you can set the charge level 2 for it. Now, I've set my current kilowatt hour rate here in Spain, where we are at the moment. I think it's about 24 cents per kilowatt hour. So that's what I'm using to calculate what kind of savings I'm getting. Firmware updates, had some of them already. Network settings, it's pretty self-explanatory there. So there's a lot of options, but my favorite screen is not this one, but space. When you get here, you get the overview. You can see that I've saved now 52 cents, which is not a lot. The power used today there and power generated and consumption right now. This is live stats connected up wirelessly. Now, if you tap here, this is my favorite screen. I really love the way it represents everything. You can see the flow of our energy here. So right now I have the solar panels going into the inverter. They are then going into other loads of my house. And the smart plugs. So one of them, which is my tower PC at the moment, 113 watts. Power grid, nothing. We've got some of the energy is going back into charging up the battery a little. And if I was to set the load from 320 watts, which I currently have, if I increase that to 800, then it'll be the other way around. Some of the battery would then be helping boost that up to get that 800 watts total. Now you can go through all your stats, all of your energy consumed, generated, from day to week to month to year. A lot of information in here, really good. So this is what you need with a setup like this with a microinverter anyway. And finally, I'll show you the plugs here. So I've got the smart plug here, one of them set to the biggest consumer of the household. For us, all on electric, is our water boiler, okay? So this is using a lot of power at the moment. I don't have it on, but you can manually turn it on and off. You can set it on a timer. So I can have this only come on during the day when we're generating energy from the sunshine, from the solar panels, from EcoFlow. You can turn it off, have a delayed off there. There's firmware updates, and there's also this too as well, overload protection. Very good. So getting out of that, I'll just show you the last one, which is my tower PC. Same thing there. I can see it's currently using 110 watts. It'll give me the stats of all of this, which is great there. So there's plenty in here, a lot of information, and I just love how it shows the flow of where the power is going, what you're generating, what you're consuming, and you're using, and this is great.
Now, if you're wondering if this will be able to power your whole house, I did a little test. I turned off the power at the switchboard, and I tried to get this unit here to run at least just the lights and some low-powered items in the house, but nothing happened at all. So it's not going to be a solution for blackouts. The battery bank itself is, if you connect up to it directly, but it won't be able to run your lights, your house, and your household appliances. At 800 watts, this is the limitation of this unit here, so it's not going to be able to run, for example, your hot water cylinder, your hot water heater in our household. It can't do that because that's about 1.4 kilowatts. This is only 800 watts. And those domestic items, your appliances, for example, your ovens, stove tops, all those sort of things, it's not going to be able to power those at all. But what it can do is take away some of the load from those items there because it's feeding that power into your house there. So that's really good. It's going to cut down a little bit on your power bills. It's not a completely standalone solution that you'd just be able to run that. Now, for people that maybe have a RV setup that you normally would be powering, you might be able to plug this into it and you probably have a sufficient power there with the 800 watts, depending again on what you're using. So it does have its limitations, but it is a really good setup and I like the application. The way you can see the flow of energy is very handy, all the information you do get. And the smart plugs too, you can then control those remotely. You can see what kind of wattage they're using and they even do have the overload protection. And then the Delta 2 Max, well, this is a very good portable battery station that has a lot of power using the LFP battery cells. So that means it's good for around 10 years. The 3000 cycles as mentioned, it will only then drop down to 80% the capacity of those batteries. So this unit here is too very powerful, the 2400 watts. So thank you so much for watching this video here on the PowerStream microinverter, the Delta 2 Max, and the rigid 400 watt panels here from EcoFlow.